This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Sreenivasan. I'm joined by John Merrow, who you've seen on the NewsHour if you're a viewer. If not, he covers education-related matters. We're talking primarily today a new book that he's got out called The Influence of Teachers. And it's really fascinating. Just in the past couple of years since I've been at the NewsHour, I've seen so many of your stories focus on this massive shift that's happening in how people are thinking about education. And is this a kind of a struggle and a battle that's being waged in school district by school district across the country?
It's a national struggle. It's fascinating. There are two camps. There are a powerful group of people who say the problem in education is we just don't have enough good people. We need better people. And on that side, you have, there was a documentary, a very flawed documentary called Waiting for Superman. You have Oprah. You have NBC's Education Nation. You've got Michelle Reed, Joel Klein, Teach for America, saying we need better people. On the other side, a much weaker side, say, no, you have to make teaching a better job. If you make teaching a better job, then a lot of things will happen. Unfortunately, better job has been defined by unions and school boards as how late can you get there in the morning, how soon can you leave after the last bell, how many days in advance does a principal have to ask before he or she can come watch you teach. I mean, a very trade union definition. But if you could take that definition away and define better job differently, my hunch is things would change, but there's a huge battle going on.
And you're talking about a teaching force that's absolutely enormous.
Yeah, it's a country of 311 million people. There are 3.2 million teachers. One out of every 100 Americans, and that includes children, one out of every 100 Americans is a public school teacher. We have more public school teachers than doctors, lawyers, social workers, and higher ed teachers combined. It's huge, and it's growing, by the way.
And yet 40% of the teachers that sign up are out of the system in 5 years.
At least 40%. And in high-need schools, it's even higher churn. That one piece of data says that the problem is not better people. The problem is we have to make it a better job. I mean, I think if we can make teaching a better job, and what teachers want, and as I spell out in the book, they want a chance to collaborate. Mm-hmm. To be part of the curriculum development, to watch each other teach. I mean, that's when you ask teachers what would make the job more satisfying, it's stuff like that. It's not necessarily more money. Here's a staggering piece of information. In 1987, you remember the difference of median, mean, and mode, right? Mode is the most common.
Different averages.
Yeah. In 1987, the modal years of experience was 15 years. There were more teachers who had 15 years of teaching experience than any other kind, 13-year experience, 5-year experience. And today, the mode, I almost want to ask you to guess, the mode is 1 year. We have more first-year teachers than any other kind of teacher. Now, that was 2007 data, so maybe it's 2 years now. But there's this huge churn. So one out of every 100 Americans is a teacher. Teaching force is getting greener in terms of
experience.
Yeah, it's also getting older, though, because there's this whole cadre of teachers moving through who are going to retire. It's getting whiter. It's getting more female. So is this a crisis? Is this an opportunity? I think it's a huge opportunity. You got these young people who are technologically, who are the natives, if you will, coming in. If we can change schools so that they become places where kids learn to formulate questions, instead of them being these regurgitation education answer factories, we have a chance to really make a difference. So it's a great time.
So finally, you've had an opportunity to view so many different teaching styles. Yeah. You've been in hundreds of classrooms around the country. You've been able to profile, say, the Paul Vallis's of this recovery school district in New Orleans and the Michelle Rees in Washington, D.C. Have you seen a system that's working? I think in the book somewhere you mentioned that Seattle has certain things that are going for it. Are there little lessons that we can pick up from around the country and say, this is how I would design a really great school system that values teachers, values the administration, but also really at the center of it all values the kids that are getting this?
There is no system you can point to that has done it. You can point to schools, you can point to classrooms, and that's really the conundrum, is why can't we point to systems? My sense, Hari, is that what happens with a system is they haven't figured out how to put the needs of kids first. But in schools that are effective, successful, and in classrooms that are effective and successful, The question they ask is, how are you intelligent? Not, how intelligent are you? And in a way, that, you know, that construct says so much. Because if I'm asking, how are you intelligent, and finding out and saying, we're going to build on your strengths. Well, this guy is really interested in athletics. Fine, good. Well, we're going to teach you to read and write and do math and numbers using athletics. Why not? But that says we're going to do a lot of project-based stuff, too.
All right. John Merrow, the author of The Influence of Teachers, as well as a special correspondent that covers education for the NewsHour. You can get the book at Amazon, and the proceeds go to Learning Matters. It's a nonprofit.
They go to Learning Matters, which means they allow us to cover education for the NewsHour.
All right. Thanks for joining us.
Absolutely. Thank you very much.
This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Sreenivasan. Stay with us.